Hello students, welcome for today's practical session. In today's practical session, we are going to learn about estimation of proteins by using bioreact method. I am Professor M.G. Shinde, KKV College of Pharmacy, Nasik. Welcome to all of you for today's practical sessions. The learning objectives of today's practical session aim, principle, procedure, observation, result. So, very first of all, let's start with the aim. So, the aim of today's practical is to estimate the proteins by using bioreact method. For this practical, the requirement is apparatus, glassware. We require test tube stands, beaker, glass rod, water bath, calorimeter, etc. In the chemicals, we required sample of protein solution, bioreact reagent, protein standard solution, distilled water, etc. Now, introduction to the proteins. Proteins are made up of amino acids which are linked together by peptide linkages. Chemically, they contain the COOH bond peptide in a polypeptide chain. Proteins are classified as simple protein, conjugate protein, complex proteins. Now let's begin with the principle behind today's practical. The COOH bond, that is a peptide bond present in the polypeptide chain, reacts with the copper sulfide in an alkaline medium to give purple color, which can be measured at 540 nanometer. Actually, the protein sample is allowed to react the bioreact reagent which contain the copper sulfates, and in alkaline medium these copper sulfates present in the bioreact reagents that will produce this purple color. We have to measure a color intensity produced by this bioreact reagent with the protein sample. This color intensity of purple color for different sample we have to measure, and for the unknown sample we have to take the unknown absorbance by plotting the graph of absorbance versus concentration. We can, from the known absorbance, we can find out the unknown concentration of the proteins. By this way we can estimate the protein sample by using this bioreact method. So the procedure, very first of all, we have to take a set of different pipettes. We have to pipette out 0, 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8 and 1 ml of working standard into the series of labeled test tubes. Then we have to pipette out 1 ml of given sample in another test tubes. Make up the volume to 1 ml in all test tubes. A tube with the 1 ml of distilled water which serve as the blank. Now in each tube we have to add 3 ml of bioreact reagent, including test tubes which is labeled as blank and unknown. Mix the content of the tubes by shaking the tubes and warm at 37 degree for 10 minutes. Now cool the contents to room temperature and record the absorbance at 540 nanometer against blank. Then we have to plot a standard curve by taking concentration of protein along the x-axis and absorbance at 540 nanometer along y-axis. Then from this standard curve, calculate the concentration of protein in the given sample. Now we are actually going to perform this practical in laboratory.
Students, here we are actually going to perform the practical for estimation of proteins by bioreact method. For this, we required the requirements of glassware. So here we required set of test tubes, the test tube stands, pipettes of different capacities, 5 ml, 10 ml, 1 ml. Beaker of capacity to 50 ml and 100 ml. Apart from this, we required some chemicals. So very first of all, we required a sample solution of proteins distilled water bioreactor reagents. The principle behind the estimation of proteins by bioreactor method is that whenever the peptide bonds present in the protein sample when reacted with this alkaline copper sulfate present in the bioreactor region, that will give formation of copper peptide complex, and that complex having a purple color. So now our target is we have to measure the color concentration of this color intensity of this complex with the help of colorimetry. For this, very first of all we have marked the test tubes with the different concentrations. So we have to take 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8 and 1 ml of concentration of proteins. Next step is addition of distilled water. So in first test tube, that is 0, we have to add completely 1 ml of water. Addition of bioreactor reagent. We have to add 3 ml of bioreactor in each test tube. Each test tube we have to add 3 ml of bioreactor reagent. We have to make unknown, we have to take the unknown concentration of sample and make the volume to 1 ml by water, and finally we have to add 3 ml of this bioreactor reagent. We have to mix all this content thoroughly. At all the test tube having different color develops. So lastly we have to find out the color intensity of each H2 with the help of, or we have to measure the color intensity with the help of colorimeter. So this is our unknown. Now after mixing these solutions, we have to keep it for 10 minutes for incubation in the water bath at about temperature 37 degree. After incubating the test tubes for 10 minutes at about 37 degree, there is development of different colors counts according to the their concentration of the protein samples. So now we will check the absorbance at 540 nanometers. For this, very first of all we require a colorimeter. Make it on. Now we have to, so first we will take 0, that is blank. And we have to set it to 0. Now next we will take the reading for 0.2 ml concentration of the protein sample. Each time after taking the concentration, we have to wash the cuvette. And we have to take reading for the next concentration. Next, we will take the reading for the next concentration. So this is about, we have to record it, that is next we will take the reading for the next concentration. Each time after taking the concentration, we have to wash the cuvette, and we have to take reading for the next concentration. So this is the final concentration. Lastly, we have to take the reading for unknown concentration. So this is the unknown concentration. All the readings, we have to wash the cuvette properly. Now the next step is plotting of all these concentrations. We have to plot the graph of concentration of protein sample with that of absorbance. So we will plot the graphs and we will find out the readings. Finally, we have to note down this observation table. So whatever the observation table here, the table should contain serial number, volume of standards, that is 0 ml, 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8 and 1 ml, and that is last one is unknown. Now volume of distilled water we have adjusted to 1 ml for first, for second 0.8 ml because we have taken 0.2 ml standard, for the third 0.6 ml as 0.4 ml third concentration for the sample, similarly 0.4, 0.2 and 0, and unknown we have to take directly. The concentration of protein here present in all each test tube is, for the first blank is 0, second which is containing 0.2 ml that contain 1 milligram, second third contain 2 milligram, fourth contain 3 milligram, 4 milligram, 5 milligram and unknown, which is to be we have to estimate. Now lastly we have added bioreactor reagent, that is 3 ml to each test tube, and incubated at 37 degree for 10 minutes. So after color development we have taken the absorbance of each test tube, we found a blank 0, we have to adjust it 0, then we have taken absorbance for the 0.2 ml concentration which we got 0.22, similarly for 0.4 that is 0.26, 0.6 is 0.30, 0.8 it is 0.32, and 1 ml concentration we got the absorbance 0.37. We have taken the unknown for which we got 0.29. Now we have to calculate, we have to plot the graph and we have to find out the unknown concentration. Here we have to plot the graph of concentration on x axis and absorbance on y axis, and finally from the graph we have to find out the concentration for unknown, which is for which the absorbance is 0.29. Plot this. So we will plot this graph and we will find out the unknown concentration here.
Clean laboratory. Now after performing the observations, so we have recorded this absorbance at 540 nanometer. So for the first test tube which is blank, that is 0. For the second test tube with the 0.2 ml concentration, that is the concentration of protein is 1 milligram per ml, is shows absorbance is 0.22. next concentration shows absorbance 0.26. the 0.6 concentration shows absorbance 0.30. 0.8 it shows 0.32, and for 1 ml concentration is 0.37. so on the basis of this absorbance table, we have to take absorbance for unknown, which is 0.29. Now we'll plot the graph of absorbance versus concentration. So this is the graph of concentration versus absorbance, and from the above graph the unknown concentration found is 0.57. So this is 0.5 mark, this is 0.5, and this is about 0.57. so the unknown concentration found is 0.57. now if 1 ml of protein sample solution contain 5 milligram of protein, then 0.57 ml of unknown will contain x milligram of protein. So from cross multiplication we will get the unknown concentration, that is 2.85 milligram per ml. So finally the result is, the unknown concentration of protein estimated by using bioreactor reagent is found 2.85 milligram of protein. Now let us see some viva questions. Objective questions: what are proteins? Proteins are amino. Proteins are the polypeptide chains which are made up from the amino acid linked together by a peptide bond. What is bioreactor agent? The bioreactor agent is a solution containing copper sulfate, sodium potassium tartrate in sodium hydroxide and also it contains potassium iodide. Finally, we have to make up the volume with the sodium hydroxide. So in presence of copper sulfate, proteins will give a purple color as it contains peptide bond. This peptide bond reacts with the copper sulfate in alkaline medium. Next question, write principle behind estimation of protein by bioread method. Proteins contain a peptide in the polypeptide chain which reacts with the copper sulfate in presence of alkaline medium. So this will give a purple color. We have to measure the color intensity produced by the purple color for different concentration, and by plotting the absorbance versus concentration, we can estimate the unknown concentration. Next question, which color is produced by the bioread reagent with the proteins? So here a purple color is developed whenever copper sulfate reacts with the peptide bond which present in the protein sample. Now next we will see some MCQs. First, proteins are made up from, there are options glucose, maltose, amino acids and amylopectins. The correct option is C, that is amino acid. Next MCQ, proteins are made up of amino acids which are linked together by. So there are options peptide bond, glycosidic linkage, ether linkage, none of the above. Correct option is peptide bond. Polypeptide chain reacts with the copper sulfate in an dash dash medium to give purple color. So options are acidic, alkaline, neutral, none of the above. Correct option is here, that is alkaline medium. Polypeptide chain reacts with the copper sulfate in alkaline medium to give which color? Options are red, orange, yellow and purple. Correct option is here, purple. Finally, the last question is, bioread reagent is made up of from. It contains cupric hydroxide, copper sulfate, cupric oxide, cuprous oxide. Correct option is B, that is it contains copper sulfate which in alkaline medium produces purple color with the